semua. Bersama saya adalah YB Raya, Ahli Parlimen untuk kawasan Parlimen Jelutong. Kami membuat sidang media ini selepas satu laporan polis yang saya buat semalam berhubung dengan kematian pelajar Nigeria dalam tahanan imigresen Bukit Jalil. Tujuan saya membuat laporan polis ini adalah untuk satu siasatan atau inquest bebas dilakukan ke atas sebab-sebab yang membawa kepada kematian beliau dalam tahanan imigresen di negara kita sendiri. Saya ingin membaca press release. Ini adalah joint statement YB Raya dan saya tapi dalam bahasa Inggeris. An independent inquiry committee must be set up to investigate into the series of events like immigration SOP before and while in detention that led to the death of Nigerian student Orhions Ewansiha Thomas while being detained in the Bukit Jalil Immigration Detention Centre. It is a week since the passing of the Nigerian PhD student Orhions Ewansiha Thomas in the Immigration Detention Centre, who was pursuing his studies in Lim Kok Wing University. And yet no heads have rolled, neither has there been a statement of an internal investigation by the Immigration Department to probe into the series of events that led to his sudden death. All foreign students who are pursuing their education in Malaysia are given an I-card, an identity card that carries all information about the student, including the validity of the student visa, the course that they are pursuing, and the university or college in which they are students in. The use of this I-card came to effect after it was gazetted on 22nd February last year and is the only card that is recognised by the Immigration Department, which will prove if the holder has a valid pass and is equipped with a biometric chip and permanent identification number, which is recognised by all enforcement agencies. In the case of the Nigerian student, it would have taken only a few hours to verify if he was indeed a student from Lim Kok Wing University by keying in the information into a system that exists in all major detention centres to verify that indeed his story checks out. Was it done? Instead, he was never brought to court in front of a magistrate to be given a chance to defend himself before his 14-day remand was meted out to him, with the only reason given, which was to check the validity of his travel documents. If he was suspected for any crime in the country, then he must be brought to court to be heard and for him to put in his defence with a right to a lawyer and with knowledge of his embassy. Nothing like that happened, and today we are faced with the death of a good man, a husband, father and student in our own immigration detention centres. This sort of overzealous enforcement SOP, which has already put a black mark on our immigration department, must be looked into seriously as it will affect the reputation of Malaysia in the eyes of the world. Foreign students who come into Malaysia to pursue their careers with a solid foundation in education contribute over 3 billion ringgit per year. And if the treatment of foreign students, foreign workers or even undocumented foreigners, whether migrants or victims of trafficking, does not improve in our immigration detention camps, then Malaysia will again make global headlines as a nation with no regard to human rights, rule of law and respecting the dignity of a person. While I am in no way criticising the duty of the Immigration Department to vet, document and manage the influx of refugees, traffic victims and undocumented foreigners due to economic or religious persecution, they must redevelop a new SOP on how foreigners are managed in our detention centres, which are also notorious of being dirty, unhygienic, and the treatment of them, whether male or female, is sometimes beyond imagination. So we are calling for an investigation, an independent investigation, an inquiry to probe into what led to his death. The autopsy report can say something, but the SOP of immigration, as we all know, I think all of this needs to be improved. You have to study the current SOP and how the immigration manages foreign workers, how it manages foreign students, how it manages traffic victims is something that always propels the immigration to make headlines in a bad light. So we are doing this so that the immigration will take note of this suggestion and work on it as soon as possible before we have more deaths in our immigration camps.
And as far as this particular case is concerned, I think we must put it on record that YB Kasthuri is the first person who has lodged a police report. So now officially the police must carry out investigations and maybe even hold an inquest. No police reports have been lodged so far on this particular case. Of course, the police have carried out a post-mortem, but this particular police report will then trigger the necessity for the police to carry out investigations. And the purpose of lodging this police report is to basically urge the police to hold a public inquest because there are many Nigerian students here, foreigners. I'm not sure whether the Nigerian embassy is taking any action, but we hope with this police report, there could be a public inquest to find out the actual cause of death.
Maybe